Hello everybody and welcome to another StarCraft 2 cast featuring yours truly, Sai StarCraft. This is a short ZVZ, but it was really funny and it's kind of a silly example of something you can do against Zerg cheese. I hope that doesn't spoil it at all, but it's a pretty fun ZVZ, so watch all of it or else I will castrate your firstborn female. And yes, you can castrate females. You chop off their clit. Ooh, that's just gross to think of. You have to have like a giant bodybuilder muscly clit to even be able to chop something like that off. But anyway, it's a Zerg versus Zerg. I am Vile Sai in the bottom right as the blue Zerg. Check out vilegaming.com and follow our team. And my opponent is Daisuke, probably from some anime, that's what I would guess, in the bottom left as the red Zerg. Already we're seeing something crazy. He went 6 pull and he's droning up once, so he's going to be going for a all-in rush pretty much. That's really what anything before a 10 pull is an all-out rush. Now, lucky for him, he will be in a closer position. Actually, these positions are pretty much the same length, but he will scout me, so he'll know where to run at least. So those overlords have crossed, and if they didn't cross, he would just assume I would be in the cross positions. But as you can see, I'm building up to 14, and normally on Shakura's Plateau, I like to fast expand. Daisuke, however, not a huge fan of that. He is making 6 lings, and he's sending them straight to my base, so I'm going to be hard-pressed to defend against these lings. Looks like I'm going to expand now, and my spawning pool is nowhere near completion, even starting at least. And 8 more lings, 8 lings total, and there goes my expansion. And he's sending all of his drones, sending 4 drones, leaving one behind to mine some minerals probably, maybe send in another batch of lings once this guy mines enough. But the thing about me is once I hatch, I love to get a lot of drones before I make a spawning pool. I like to build back up to 16, and I still have not started my pool. Now I'm preparing to start my pool, and had I known he was going to do this, see, I can just now scout this with my overlord. Had I known he was going to do this, I would have built my spawning pool in a much safer location, maybe like tucked behind my mineral lines or something safer. Now here comes Daisuke. I obviously know these lings are going to come. I can't see him with the hatchery, but I know they're going to come because of this overlord. I see that one drone, and this is where I'm ready to... Number one, don't get gas. You do not want gas in this situation. Number two, produce an overlord. Number three, save larva. Now, in this situation, I'm not saving larva because I don't think my spawning pool will actually finish, so I want as many drones to defend this as I can. And you might be thinking, cancel your hatchery. You need that money. No, my money's fine. That hatchery is going to come into play later, and I knew that when this was happening. When your opponent is doing this kind of strategy, you want to try to float your drones past his lings and get a surround on them. Now you can see here I do that a little bit with one ling, I'm able to catch him, but you don't want to engage like that. So I'm going to be floating to the mineral lines, and notice he's not engaging because he's afraid I'll float to these minerals and then attack command. And that is a lot of drones, man. Drones aren't too shabby against lings. He does let the pool finish, however. Big mistake, and because this pool finishes, 4 lings on the way, 6 lings on the way, all 6 from my main hatchery. And now this is kind of the critical moment in the game. You can float, but in this situation, I just want to wait for lings. Floating would cause my drones to take a ton of damage, but if you stack your drones repeatedly, it's like stacking against a wall off. Your opponent will only have a little bit of surface area to attack your drones, and also, your drones will do a lot of damage. See, I'm doing quite a bit of damage to his lings, and they're not taking that much damage themselves. Only 3 going down, a couple more going down into red and yellow. And, you know, all I need to do is survive at this point. My lings are out, and now he's going to try to bait me back to the spine, but I'm not going to have that. And this is where that extra hatchery comes into play. He does have an advantage in the main base with my spine, but I'm just going to move to the extra hatchery. Keep mining there. Keep in mind, he does only have one drone here still. He's just continuing to make lings. Now he's going to uproot and plant that spine there. If he tried to uproot and plant the spine here, I would just outnumber him with my drones and lings. He only has, one ling left in the main, so... That drone trick was actually able to snipe quite a few lings. I don't know where all his lings went, actually. But the spawning pool will eventually go down, but he really should have been focusing the pool earlier. I think he just wanted to prevent any kind of broodlings from coming out. I think that's why he wasn't killing the spawning pool so fast. But alas, the pool will go down. I am sending 2 of my own lings to snipe that additional drone. Looks like he noticed that, and he's actually going to send that drone to attack. And broodling is not able to kill any drones, maybe kill one drone, and he's focusing down the hatchery, but pretty sure he realizes I have another base. Yeah, he does realize I have another base. He probably thought I canceled it. He goes and scouts it and realizes, no, you did not cancel it. I've got a spine on the way. I've got 16 lings to his 5 lings, and I have way more drones that are actually mining and not just beating on a spawning pool. So kind of a fun little game right there. You can still win games, even if you get 6 pooled and you're going like tons and tons of drones with that kind of micro. Could Daisuke have played it better? Yes, he could have. I think he could have killed the pool earlier and just dealt with the broodlings. Maybe micro does links a little better against my drones, but this stacking trick that you saw there is very, very useful. It's so good in any situation, and it kind of hard counters early pool builds. I gotta say, that's really cool. Ping, ping, ping. But I hope you guys enjoyed that. It was a short one. I know you guys sometimes are a bit hesitant about watching short ones, but it was pretty exciting. So I hope you enjoyed it. As always, thanks for watching. I don't have my GG button, so let's just have Siri say something to me. I hate you, Siri.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, you better be sorry, bitch.